In case you haven't heard, scientists just discovered a new exoplanet circling our nearest neighbor in the Alpha Centauri group, Proxima Centauri. Alpha Centauri is actually a binary star, locked together in orbit. It is our closest neighbor, around 4.7 light years away, and has been the focal point of sci-fi for decades, especially when Mars was found to be inhospitable for intelligent life. The stars are also like our sun, which adds to the sci-fi speculation, though unfortunately we haven't found any signs of life there. Proxima Centauri is gravitationally attached to the large pairs, but at the distance Neptune is from the sun, so it's been difficult to find exoplanets using current means. It is also a red dwarf, which creates its own set of complexities. Well, they discovered Proxima B, a rocky planet 1.3 times the size of Earth within the habitable zone, but just barely. It has an average temperature of negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit, which is oddly also negative 40 degrees Celsius. Like most planets around red dwarfs, Proxima B is probably tidally locked, meaning one side always faces the sun and the other is always frozen. It's possible this one is not, as it's so far out in the habitable zone, but we will assume it is. Red dwarfs used to be considered bad candidates for life, as they give off massive X-ray flares, relatively periodically, that overall are 4,000 times the intensity the sun gives off, which could wipe out an entire Earth-like population. Probably why Superman has so many powers when he came to our planet. It also will be pretty dry on the light side of the planet, as most of the water will be collected into ice on the dark side, unless there's way more water than there is on Earth. However, red dwarfs have one advantage yellow suns like ours don't. Time. Our sun will eventually run out of fuel and expand to a red giant before it becomes a white dwarf. Red dwarfs, on the other hand, are incredibly stable and could have been around when the first generation stars were formed, while our sun is probably a third generation star. So they have billions more years of evolution to tinker around with biology if life forms in the first place. Animals would either have to live underwater, which is unlikely due to dryness, have an early warning system to burrow underground, and the X-ray flares do give off prior warnings, or they could have developed a wolverine or salamander-style genetic repair system, or methods to redirect X-rays around genetic material and vital areas using electromagnets like an eel, mixed with traits of certain types of bacteria that sequester hematite like I've tested in the lab, or perhaps they use lead the same way. If the planet spun on its axis perpendicular to the sun, the planet could have a spinning core powering a magnetic field that could also deflect some of the X-rays, though low likelihood. Interesting thing about a tidally locked planet is that the side facing the sun will actually have a spot that reaches boiling temperatures that produces a constant hurricane, much like Jupiter's red spot, but for completely different reasons. However, if there was a way to have seas or oceans in the warm zone, there would be good areas to live. The equator would be in constant twilight, about the temperature of our Arctic area. The rest of the sun-facing area would get warmer and warmer the closer you got to the hot pole. The mass of the ice on one side would cause periodic shifts in weather and climate, allowing the sun side to have wet and dry times, though they may be decades to millions of years of cycles. They could also be defended from massive impacts of comets and asteroids, as they would most likely hit the cold side, which would mess with their weather, but would probably recover much more quickly with a massive cold collecting water and atmospheric debris that would normally cause a nuclear winter here on Earth. The idea of day and night would not exist. Dark and light would be locations. If the planet somehow developed intelligent life, only people living like our Inuit would even know that stars exist, and all of astronomy would have to be done similar to our Antarctic research bases. They may very well develop rocketry and satellite before many of them knew the level of astronomy that Copernicus knew. They would have roughly the surface area of Mars with Earth-like temperatures to evolve on, with distinct bands of habitats to allow for diversity, and with a massive evolutionary head start on us that they could make up for in spite of the constant X-ray flares. The people of Proxima B may also develop sustainable energy before burning fossil fuels due to constant sunlight. Solar panels will be the most efficient, and they could create long pipelines similar to core drilling into the center of the boiling hurricane to tap steam for power, or they could create a ring of wind farms around the central hurricane. Fossil fuels would be used solely for cold side exploration and emergency. Sadly, they wouldn't get our radio signals in any intelligible form, as after 1 to 2 light years, they end up scrambled, though a radio array on their cold side could tell them that we are inhabited when they decide that the effort is worth the money. The really cool thing about this planet is that with the operation of the James Webb Telescope in 2018 to 2019, along with more space telescopes over the next 10 years, we will be able to visibly observe the planet and find out if it has oxygen, water, and other signs of life. Scientists are working on a moonshot project that could send microprobes at 1/4 the speed of light using lasers that could get them there in 20 years. Sadly, the tech is roughly 50 years away, so unless life extension hopes by science pays off, most of us won't get to see the probe's results. It's still pretty damn amazing and inspires hope that the search for life in our galaxy may be right next door. Though it will probably be a lifeless barren rock with insufficient water or oxygen, but we can always dream like we did about Mars until we found out the truth and then moved our attention on to the next closest, like Wolf-1061C. The Extraterrestrials documentary called Aurelia creates a hypothetical ecosystem on a planet circling a red dwarf. I highly recommend it. You can find it on YouTube. Link is in the below bar. Hey there. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked what you saw from my channel, please subscribe and donate to my Patreon. If you have evidence to counter what I say, please provide it. If you would like to see what I was doing with this channel 6 years ago, please click the links on the screen. Thank you so much.